We thank the Lord for giving us the gift of life. It's my pleasure to see you today again. And I know that God, who has been blessing us, will not hesitate to do likewise today as we share together from His Word. My name is Joseph Idowu Samson from Emmanuel Baptist Church, Odono, Apata, Ibadan. Shall we pray together? Heavenly Father, the time has come again to speak to us. Lord, I ask that you will empower your word and you will cause your word to minister to our lives in Jesus' name. Thank you because you have answered. In Jesus' mighty name, I pray. Amen. Praise the Lord. This morning, I want to share with you what I titled, Do Not Forget. Do Not Forget. I take my text from Psalm 105. And I'm going to read verses 1 to 7. The book of Psalm 105. I'm going to read verses 1 to 7. Oh, give thanks unto the Lord. Call upon his name. Make known his deeds among the people. Sing unto him. Sing psalms unto him. Talk ye of all his wonderful works. Glory ye in his holy name. Let your hearts rejoice that seek the Lord. Seek the Lord and his strength. Seek his face evermore. Remember his marvelous work that he hath done, his wonders, his judgment of his mouth. O ye seed of Abraham, his servant, ye children of Jacob, his chosen. He is the Lord our God. His judgments are in all the earth. May the Lord bless the reading of his word in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Do not forget. As I was preparing for this morning devotion, I was asking God, I said, God, is it possible for man to forget you? Is it possible for human being to forget you? And God said, yes. I have seen several people, my children, that has forgotten me. I said, God, how? And God said, open to Psalm 106 and read two places. And God showed me verses 13 and 20. Let me read that place to you. Psalm 106 in verse 13 and verse 21. Verse 13 says, they soon forget his works. They waited not for his counsel. In verse 21, listen very carefully. They forget God, their Savior, which had done great things in Egypt. And I said, God, these are children of Israel. God said, yes, they are my children. They forget what I did for them. No wonder. God said, they started complaining. They started murmuring. They started grumbling because of little challenges. And God said, that is how some of you are doing today. You just forget what God has done in your life so soon. You forget the goodness of God in your life so soon. You forget the greatness and faithfulness of God, his sustenance in your life so soon. God said, that is what some of you are doing. You have forgotten me, the source of life, your hope, your sustainer, your help. God said, you have forgotten me. And as I studied our text carefully, there are two things I saw in that text, and I'm going to share with you. Number one, an exaltation to remember to worship God. An exaltation to remember to worship God. Look at our text again from verse 1. Oh, give thanks unto the Lord. Do you see that? Oh, give thanks unto the Lord. Call upon his name. Make known his deed among the people. Sing unto him. Sing psalms unto the Lord. Talk ye of his wonder. And from where I have read now, there are certain things I discover from that scripture. Do you know that if there is anything we must not forget in life as God's children, dear listeners, it should be our art, A-R-T, and our art, A-C-T, of gratitude to God. Do you hear that? You need to remember And it must be your habit and act of gratitude to God, your maker, for what he has done. And how do we do that? How do we show our appreciation, our act of gratitude to God for what he has done in our lives? Number one, from our text, the Bible says, oh, give thanks. True thanksgiving. Have you thanked the Lord today? You slept and you woke up. Do you think it's a right? Do you think it's your right? No. It is the mercy of God. You does not merit it. Do you know several people slept yesterday night and this morning they are no more? Even as you are listening to me now, some people are weeping. Some people are mourning. And yet, you did not appreciate what God has done. David said, oh, give thanks. So how do we remember God? How do we worship God? Through our thanksgiving. Give thanks to the Lord for what he has done. Brother, give thanks to him for what he has done in your life. You have forgotten the provisions. You have forgotten the Jordan message. The accident you had some years ago, some months ago, and you are the only survivor of that accident. You have forgotten that stray bullet that suddenly hit your stomach and people thought you cannot survive it. They rushed you to the hospital and blood was gushing from your body. Your clothes were soaked with blood and people were crying. Your family members were weeping and saying, oh, this man has gone. And suddenly, after a few days, you survive it and today you are alive. You are forgotten. Give thanks unto the Lord for what he has done. You've forgotten moments, days that you don't have money. No food at all. The man was sharing with me that a few days ago in their family, there was nothing. No rice, no beans, no nothing at all, no yam. And they were praying. The only flour, about few cups that they had, the mother baked, you know, he made something like puff in the morning. And everybody ate, and nothing else in the house. And they were praying, trusting God. And suddenly, that same morning, a woman came and knocked at their door with food stuff, with beans, with rice, with garri, and everything. The woman brought it for them. And they said, God, is this the way you answer prayer? And they started giving thanks unto the Lord. Brothers, you've forgotten the sustenance, the provision, because of these little challenges that you are passing through, and you are forgotten God. Remember what he has done. Remember what he is doing, and give thanks. And what he's going to, in fact, what he has not done. Give thanks to him and say, God, I thank you. Though there is no money now, but I know my Redeemer liveth. Though I am surrounded with battle, but I know God will not leave me in the hands of my enemy. Give thanks to God. The Bible said again in that verse, pray unto him. Prayer is communion. Do you know? You have ceased from relating with God. You have ceased from communing with God. Your koinonia with God has ceased because of the mundane things of this world. Prayer is an act of fellowship with God. It's an act of worship of to God. Give thanks unto the Lord. Pray unto him. David said in that verse 2, he said, give testimony. Make known his wonders among the people. That is testimony. Give share testimony of what God has done in the past. Encourage somebody. Don't let your heart be downcast. Don't be overwhelmed with these things that you are passing through. Share testimony. David says, I will sing praises unto the Lord. Brother, have you sing praises to the Lord today? I have seen the Lord goodness, his mercies and compassion. Oh Lord, you have been so good. These are wonderful, wonderful songs you sing unto the Lord to appreciate what he has done. When I think of the goodness of Jesus and all he has done for me, my very soul shall shout hallelujah. Sing praises, worship the name of the Lord, glorify his holy name. Brothers, rejoice in his presence and exaltation. Don't forget to remember to worship God. The second thing I'm going to share with you quickly because of my time is an exaltation to remember the faithfulness of God. Has it been faithful Has it been faithful to your husband, your wife, your children? Have you ever enjoyed the faithfulness of God for once? Look at verses 5 and 7. The Bible says, remember his marvelous works that he hath done, his wonders, his judgment of his mouth. O ye seed of Abraham, his servant. Brother, remember. Remember what God has done, his marvelous works that he has done in your life. Remember his wonders. Remember his miracles. There was a day you were sick. You were terribly sick. And when you go to the hospital, doctor said it is 50-50. And everybody was panicking. And they thought you are going to die of that ailment. You are going to die of that sickness. And suddenly, God of miracle, the great healer, came suddenly and healed you. Remember the miracles of God. Remember the wonders of God, the judgment of his mouth. When the enemy comes like a flood, remember how God stood on your side and defeated your enemy and he gave you victory. Remember the successes of the past that you have recorded. Remember the promotion. Now you are complaining. This is my 6-7 years and I've not been promoted. You are complaining. You are forgotten the promotion of the past. You were not on this level before. But God did the miracle for you. You are complaining of salary. My money is not paid. How will I survive? This is the second month and you are murmuring. You are grumbling. You are complaining here and there, brothers. You've forgotten the provision of the past. How God has met your need miraculously. Even when you least expected it. And suddenly a lot came into on your phone. And you say, God, you are wonderful. And now you have forgotten. The Bible says, do not forget. Give thanks to the Lord. Don't forget his benefit. And can I say something to you? As you continue to remember the mercy of God, the goodness of God, and you are praising him, I prophesy into your life that this month is going to be, this Ember month is going to be a month to be remembered. You'll be remembered for good. Instead of disgrace, grace of God will come upon your life and you are going to embrace fortunes. You are going to embrace favor. And that shall be for your life in the name of Jesus. Close your eyes as we pray together. Please speak with God now. Say, Lord, I am sorry for complaining. I am sorry for murmuring. I am sorry, Lord. Ask God to have mercy upon you. Lord, we thank you again for speaking to us. Glory be to your name. I pray for all my hearers this morning. The Lord, you will minister to their heart. You will encourage them as they remember you on a daily basis. Oh God, I pray the fullness of your blessing will come upon their life. Thank you, Lord Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. Thank you again for listening to us today. I want to encourage you to subscribe to this channel and as well, click on that notification bell. And please don't forget to share this goodness with someone. Share with a friend, share with a family. And we'll also be glad to receive your comments and questions. And as you do that, the Lord will bless you in Jesus' name. Thank you for listening to us. We meet same time next week in Jesus' name. Amen.